Hey guys, with October coming to an end, Halloween just right around the corner, I wanted to talk to you about my fall, let's call it lawn preservation strategy. I want to stave off winter, prolong my growing season. I'm going to tell you what I'm going to be doing. You don't have to do everything that I do or nothing. You could do nothing at all. But this is what I'm going to do, and I think you'll find it somewhat interesting. This tree is dropping leaves on the ground. This tree is also dropping leaves on the ground. In fact, all of my trees are starting to drop leaves on the ground because of a hormonal response that trees and plants and miscellaneous growing things in the yard do every fall. As temperatures start dropping, soil temperatures start dropping, a natural defense mechanism triggers. There's a scientific name for it. I'll put it on the screen. But it's like a hormone that causes the plants to pull all their energy down into the root systems. We call that winter dormancy in grass and other plants. If soil temperatures drop too much, there's really nothing that we can do to stop dormancy from setting in. But before soil temperatures drop too much, there are a few things that we can do. Now, before I go into depth on anything, I'm just going to summarize everything right here. We're going to cut the grass. We're going to keep watering the lawn. We're going to rake up the leaves. We're going to apply biostimulants, hormones, actually. And we're going to get the timing right on all of these things. And if we really want to go the extra mile, we can apply some very light dose minor nutrient fertilizers to the lawn. And if your soil temperatures are still high enough, you could probably get in a nitrogen fertilizer with a potassium, which is going to help your plants resiliency during stress to begin with. Any plant that, or any grass plant that has adequate potassium in its tissues is going to fare better during periods of low temperatures. All right, with my kids swinging behind me, let's talk about mowing and watering the grass. Don't worry, this will get more interesting. When we mow the grass, it stimulates growth. It just does. In the fall, especially in November, when things start getting pretty cold for whatever grass type you have, things want to slow down, but that doesn't mean that they've stopped. So by cutting the grass, every time you cut the grass, it kind of releases this natural hormone inside it that allows, I don't know, that stimulates extra growth. It's kind of like when you prune a plant, when you prune a tree or prune a bush, especially the like shrubs that go upright. If you prune it, it will start thickening out towards the bottom. That's basically what happens when we cut the grass. So even if the grass is growing very slow because of cooler temperatures, if we continue to cut it, it's going to continue growing, at least until the weather really shuts it down. Now, watering the grass serves two purposes. One, we don't want the grass to start going into winter dormancy simply because it's starting to get dehydrated in the root systems. If we're not putting water, if we turn the irrigation off and we just stop watering, and let's say we go through a stretch where there's no rain, the root systems are gonna start feeling the effects of, let's call it dehydration, and they're gonna wanna go into dormancy a little bit earlier as a defense mechanism. When overnight air temperatures drop really low in the morning, a healthy root system that is well watered is better able to push water up through into the leaf tissues and manage their internal temperature. Additionally, irrigating the lawn first thing in the morning, especially in the coldest days of the week, is going to allow the soil to actually warm up slightly faster than it would otherwise. So I like to put my sprinkler on this time of year at the time of the week that it is the coldest. If it's 35 degrees in the morning, I could turn my sprinklers on and that's gonna warm the soil temperature up a couple degrees faster than if I waited for the air and the sun to do it all on its own. That 1 or 2 degrees really is the difference in your grass shutting down, let's say for instance, November 15th instead of November 25th. Now you see here, I have some greenhouse plastic on the ground. This is a way for me to warm up the soil underneath just this strip right here because I've got a project on the ground. You can't really do this for an entire lawn. I suppose you probably could, but what's the point? You don't see the lawn. Keeping the soil temperature warm with water is really the best way, kind of the only way that makes sense to me. And it's what I'm gonna be doing for the next few weeks. Now the sun is our best friend this time of year. The sun is what the grass uses to really just create chlorophyll, photosynthesize, make energy for the plant. There's nothing that we can do about cloud cover or sunlight. This time of year, the days are shorter, so no matter what, our grass is not getting nearly as much sun as it was a couple months ago. What we can do, however,
is allow the sun to hit the grass. What little sun that we have has to hit the grass. If it doesn't hit the grass, I don't care how much sun there is. If we cover the grass up and mulch it down, maybe with leaves, then the grass under those leaves are never going to be able to create the energy that they need to stay growing. Raking up the leaves or bagging them with your mower or mulching them with your mower is very important. It allows the little sun that we have the opportunity to get to the grass. So when we're mowing, this is the time of year really that we should be using the bagger or a special mulching mower. That way we can ensure that we're constantly cutting the grass tips to stimulate more growth and keeping the grass completely free of obstacles so that the sun can actually hit it. Additionally, if there's a whole bunch of leaves on the ground and you had a nice sunny day, the sun is radiating heat onto the leaves themselves and not actually warming up the grass. The leaves end up creating this insulative layer and the soil doesn't warm up as fast. Getting the leaves off the ground regularly and often is a very important part of keeping the lawn healthy and growing as far into the fall as possible. I am slacking off. Look at this. Now the last thing that I'm gonna be doing, which is really kind of over the top for the majority of homeowners, I'm going to be applying a hormone to the ground. It's a natural plant hormone that our grass, your grass, everybody's grass makes. It's called a cytokinin. Not only do grasses make it, but pretty much every plant, every living plant makes it, as far as I know. I don't know if there's an exception to that, but I think every single plant in the world makes this stuff. One of the biggest, most concentrated sources of cytokinins are giant sea kelp varieties, which are typically harvested in the northern Atlantic off the coast of Canada. Now, I have an entire video all about sea kelp based fertilizers or sea kelp based soil amendments or biostimulants, however you want to label them. I have a whole video about how this stuff works. There's also some pretty interesting scientific papers on this stuff too. I'll link to at least one of them down below. Point being here is when our grass starts experiencing stress, in this context we're talking about cold stress, as the soil temperatures drop, the outside air temperatures get really cold overnight, that is a cold stressor on all grass types of all varieties. Each one has their own threshold and tolerances. As these grass varieties start encountering this stress, a natural hormone is released in the grass, kind of like hormones are released in humans and other animals too. The hormone is kind of like the tree that I mentioned before. Like once it starts feeling the effects of fall, it tells itself to drop its leaves. The grass is doing the same thing. Once it feels the stress of late fall, it starts telling itself to go dormant, starts shutting down, it stops growing, it slowly starts losing its color. So what we want to do in this in-between time where it's not exact, I mean, I'm in a t-shirt, it's not that cold out here, and our soil temperatures right now are about 50 degrees. There is no reason why this grass can't continue growing. So I'm going to apply cytokinins, which is the hormone that plants release to stimulate growth. And cytokinins especially push a lot of root development. Now, I talk about root development a lot on this channel because I think it's super duper important. You can get lots of different root growth stimulants, but no matter what product you use, they're almost always going to have some form of sea kelp or cytokinin in it. Now, it's highly likely that abscisic acid, the stress hormone, is still going to be released during these colder periods of the fall. But if we're putting cytokinins down on the lawn, then those cytokinins are kind of offsetting the abscisic acid, and they're continuing to push the grass further into the fall than it would otherwise. Now, there are other hormones out there that push different types of growth. I don't want to push leaf growth. Leaf growth is something, I mean, it's cool. You know, your grass is still growing tall in the middle of November, but that's not what I care about. I care about the grass staying out of dormancy until it really should be dormant. Cytokinins have been shown to be able to take the plant, like the natural plant die off of leaves. With grass, it's really like almost impossible to tell from up above. You got to get like really close, but each grass blade goes up and then there's like extra little leaves, and one grass plant could have like, you know, a whole bunch of leaves coming off of it. The older leaves die off and are replaced by new leaves.
Cytokinins, when the grass makes them themselves or they're applied as a foliar application, they get absorbed in through the leaf tissue. You could also like water them into the ground and then they'll get absorbed by the root system. No matter how you get extra cytokinins on there, they're going to stave off that dying off process. So the older leaves that start like yellowing and kind of dying off as the temperatures drop, they're going to hold on a little bit longer. The cytokinins are also going to help establish a little bit better root mass going into the winter, which is a little bit interesting because at the end of fall is not a typical root development time of year for the grass, for any grass. But because it pushes a little bit more of that, that gives the grass plant a little bit more resiliency as temperatures in the soil continue to drop. Now, because the application of extra cytokinins on this lawn are going to improve my lawn's resiliency and tolerance to the cold weathers, but not exactly push extra growth, I'm also going to be putting down a little tiny application of micronutrients. What's up, baby? Huh? What's going on? Up? Up? Even while I'm filming a video? The extra shot of micronutrients with a little bit of iron is going to give a little bit of extra color to grass that is slowly starting to get less and less and less sun. The color should persist for a lot longer simply because the grass isn't growing as much. All right, now in terms of product selection, when it comes to iron, I don't really care except for I don't prefer granular products. Now, I have nothing against ironite. It's the fact that it's a granular product. Any granular version, no matter how they label it, I just don't trust that it's not going to oxidize sitting on the soil surface, no matter how much I water it in. The iron that's in a granular product really oxidizes fast. So if you compare labels with a liquid form, the granule always has a ton more iron in it than a liquid. Now, I'm going to be putting down this liquid from Lawn Star. I don't really care which brand you use. I just prefer liquid iron products. So you're going to have to use a spreader if you want to. Otherwise, go ahead and use that. There's nothing wrong with this. You're just putting down an awful lot of stuff that's not going to be used, in my opinion. Micronutrients, I'm going to be putting down this Simple Grow Solutions. It's the micro booster. I'm not going to be putting much because, as I said, grass is growing slow because of the weather. The weather is getting cooler. We don't need a whole lot, and I've already applied micronutrients and trace minerals to this lawn earlier in the year. I just want just enough to really boost what photosynthesis I can get out of the next few weeks. The only product that I actually care a ton about in terms of the specific product is Cytogrow. Cytogrow is the product that I have used very regularly throughout the year. This is one of the only products on this channel that I actually talk quite a bit about specifically. This product is straight cytokinins. That is the purpose of this product. Sometimes you can go out and buy a product that's only nitrogen or only potassium or only something else or only iron. This is only cytokinins. This is what I care about. You can get lots of different root growth stimulant products. Their purpose is to apply these hormones to the lawn. This one is the only hormone that I care about. And it's the only thing on the label, cytokinins. I'll link to this down below. However, this is unnecessary. You don't need it. This is what I'm using to push the season into late fall by what, 10 days, maybe 2 weeks? So keep that in mind. I do use this throughout the year for other root growth promoting purposes. I have videos where I have explained much more of this stuff in detail. If you want to learn more about using iron to keep color in your lawn deeper into the fall or early in the winter, maybe even green it up before spring starts, I have a video about that linked in the description below. I have a full video, not about Cytogrow, but about sea kelp and using it in the lawn. Please watch it. It was a very difficult video for me to put together because it's hard to say a whole bunch of science stuff in a way that's palatable to the average homeowner. I also have videos about micronutrients. Those are linked down below as well. I apply micronutrients regularly, but not very much. But I also am a huge fan of applying trace minerals. Now, trace minerals come in the form of azomite or green sand. That's what I use in my lawn. I have videos about that down below. At this time of year, you're not going to apply it to the lawn and see any benefit until next year. But it's always a good thing to think about putting that stuff into your lawn soil. Go into the description, watch any of those videos. But if you don't want to go into the description at all, please watch the video up here. It's all about winter lawn mistakes that people do. Every year, in the middle of the winter, when you get bored and it's randomly warm, a ton of people are tempted to do any one, if not all, of the mistakes that I point out in that video. Take a look at it. I think you'll enjoy it. And no matter what, I hope that the rest of the fall treats you well, you have a great Thanksgiving, and a great Christmas season.